close of our service today. Several of us in the First Christian Church family welcome you, but I can assure you we are under the 10 people minimum, so do not fret. But we are glad to have you join us on this holy and sacred night. Please be sure to follow us on fcclincoln.org on our webpage, and also you can follow us on Facebook, and we do continue to update those sites so that people will know what is happening here with First Christian Church. It is a joy to have you here, and now I invite Elder Wayne Duncan to come forward and share with us God's holy word.
Our first reading this morning is from the Gospel of John, verses 31 through 35. When he was gone, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will glorify the Son in himself, and will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and just as I told the Jews, so I tell you now, where I am going, you cannot come. A new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, all men will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another." Our second reading is from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 through 26. "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.'" This ends our reading.
As we gather on Maundy Thursday, we are mindful of the meal that Jesus shares with his disciples. Now, of course, the challenge then was they didn't have to worry about physical distancing. So since they did exceed the recommended 10 people, today they probably would have gotten a fine. But then it was really a small and intimate group. We're so used to hearing the stories around Maundy Thursday and Holy Week that it's easy sometimes to conflate all the gospel narratives into one narrative in our own head. And so it's so important that we take each of the gospel narratives on their own, because each of the authors is inviting us into the story in a different way. As I say, although it would have exceeded the 10 people recommended, the 12 people that gather with Jesus in the upper room is a small and intimate group. So often on Maundy Thursday, we're used to having our soup supper and a large worship service. We gathered all the disciples' churches here last year, and it was quite a large service. So we forget that in actuality, the first Maundy Thursday would have been with Jesus and a small group of his colleagues and friends. So they gather in the upper room, and actually Wayne picks up the story at the end, and we're kind of dropped in the midst of this story that unfolds first with a Passover meal between all these friends and their teacher. But Jesus, in this Gospel of John, adds a new element that is unique to this gospel. Jesus gets up in the midst of this meal, he wraps a towel around his waist, and he proceeds to wash the feet of each of the disciples, even though Simon Peter, in his wonderful way, protests. But it's important that John lifts this story up for us because Jesus wants to tell us something unique and special about the quality of love. Maundy Thursday gets its name from the For Jesus, he wants to emphasize the idea that love is not simply an emotion or a sense of affection we might have for someone, but Jesus wants to emphasize the idea that love is service. And so he serves by washing the feet, a very humble act, usually something done by a servant in the household as guests arrive, but he does it with each of his disciples. In that way, he wants to demonstrate what servant love might look like, that there's a sense of humility involved on the one providing service, and there's also a desire for receptivity on the one receiving. And so Jesus is able to demonstrate love, and this is in a stark contrast in this gospel, of course, because we also have at the same time the parallel activity of Judas and his betrayal, his inability to love Jesus. And so we have this juxtaposition of Judas and of Jesus, and Jesus wanting to show us what servant love might look like. In this day and age of physical distancing, as we move through these days dealing with COVID-19, it is a challenge for us to think about how we might offer loving service to one another. That does require that physical distancing. I prefer that phrase because I don't think social distancing says it, because we do need to keep connected, and loving service empowers us to do that. Maybe it's simply making a phone call to someone, checking in on them, talking to them. Maybe it's dropping a note. Good thing to keep the postal service going for us. Maybe it's sending them an email or participating in a Zoom meeting. There are a lot of different ways that we too can simply serve one another, even in these days of self-isolation. And of course, the ultimate gift of this night is that Jesus gives fully of himself, and we will share in that as we share in communion a little bit later in our service, the ultimate reminder of how Jesus gave his body and blood for us. In these days of COVID-19, might we open our hearts to God's love, and in that way find small and significant ways to serve one another. And by serving one another, we serve God. Amen. By taking the bread, and he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. As often as you eat it, do this in remembrance of me." And then, as they shared their meal together, Jesus took the cup, and again he gave God thanks, and he said, "Take, drink. This is the sign of the new covenant shed in my blood. As often as you drink it, do this in remembrance of me."
Pray with me. Oh, Father God, we wait. We anticipate. We long for you. We watch. We listen. And Lord, we just thank you for all that you've done, all that you will do, and all that you are doing. Lord, let this prayer go out today and touch everybody that's watching. And we pray this prayer in Jesus' name. Please pray with me the Lord's Prayer in saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive
those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And so we know that the table is prepared and the feast is ready. Our Lord and Savior invites you to partake in its bounty. And so we know that Jesus took the bread, then he took the cup, and in that way shared in its bounty. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love